If you're running low on GTA 5 cash and need to make some money for the latest DLC, then make sure you download App Bounty in the description below. It's a free and easy way to get your hands on shark cards by downloading and playing games. Once again, link in description. This is going to be exciting. The way this Easter egg goes is that Brad's ghost will haunt the graveyard and he will push you over and drag you into the empty gravestone where he was buried. There's a crow on the angel, of course. We also have Franklin over there and Trevor just over there. I can still hear that shovel. I'm trying to phase it out so I don't have to listen to it all the time. I have this horrible feeling of just turning around and there being a ghost there. I may have said this in previous videos, but this angel really, really scares me. I think there's only one of them in the graveyard. If you guys see anything as well, let me know in the comments. I can hear it. You guys hear that too? Wait, what is that? What's that? Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Nort, and today, as you guys can tell, we're gonna revisit Brad's ghost in GTA 5 in the North Yankton Cemetery. Loads and loads of you guys have been asking me to return to this mystery, to return to this Easter egg, and that's exactly what we're gonna do in today's episode, and I am excited. At the same time, I'm pretty scared, because in the previous video, we were hearing noises which I just physically couldn't explain, and I'm really confused about what happened. Just thinking about it, I don't have an answer for it. Someone was walking behind us, and someone was also trying to speak to us through the wind, and I could also hear a buzzing or something like that coming from the gravestone. Like, really strange stuff. Stuff which you just wouldn't expect to hear in a graveyard, but that's exactly what we heard in the North Yankton Cemetery in the previous episode. And whilst we were doing that, I did actually put all of the characters in the cemetery. I had Michael, I had Franklin, I had Trevor, and they were all in the graveyard with us when we heard those noises. So maybe they had some sort of role in activating it. So what you guys were asking me to do is to bring the characters to the graveyard again and see if we can find anything else, see if we can hear anything else, or just see if anything happens, because that seems to be a good method to get things to trigger and to see Brad's ghost. Now, for those of you guys who have just tuned into this mystery and don't quite know exactly what's going on, don't worry. I'm going to leave a link to Dark Corners in the description below. He actually investigated this myth a few months ago, and he discovered some pretty spooky things, as well as actually being pushed over in the graveyard. And what people are saying is that the way this Easter egg goes is that Brad's ghost will haunt the graveyard and he will push you over and drag you into the empty gravestone where he was buried. And it does actually make sense, because if you guys think about it, Brad was wronged by his entire group in Prologue. They basically went behind his back. So it would make sense that he might be a tiny bit angry at the characters. So being able to haunt them at the graveyard is the least he could do. So this is going to be interesting. I do find these episodes extremely scary, so I do apologize if I do end up jumping under my desk, but you guys have been asking me to revisit this Easter egg, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. And I've been reading the comments and I found a few interesting ideas which you guys want me to try out in today's episode. So that's exactly what we're gonna do today. But if you guys do go on to enjoy today's episode, be sure to smash that thumbs up button. Let's try and smash that goal of 5,000 likes. I know we can do it, guys. You get it every single time, so thank you so much for that. But this is gonna be exciting, and I'm just gonna go straight over to the North Yankton Cemetery, and we're gonna start things off, guys. And I am taking a look in the comments, guys. I did notice that a few of you were asking me how to get over to North Yankton, because not every single person is able to teleport over there. So if you guys can't teleport over to North Yankton, I know there's two missions which will let you guys go over there. One of them is Prologue, the other one is Bury the Hatchet, and I think Bury the Hatchet is gonna be the best mission for you guys to check out if you want to do this mystery, if you want to investigate it and stuff. Granted, you'll be in the middle of a mission, but at least you'll be able to go straight over to the graveyard. And I think that's the only opportunity you guys can go over to the graveyard, unless you do have mods. That's a little tip if you guys want to get over to North Yankton but don't know how to. But let's continue this and let's just go over to North Yankton and let's see what we can find today, guys. I've also set the weather condition to foggy, because this seems to be the only weather in which ghosts will appear in GTA. And this is the weather condition I think Dark Corners was using when he did find this ghost. But we've heard some pretty mysterious things with this weather, so we should see some other things in today's episode. So, oh man, I can't believe we're doing this. I really can't. Let's just go over there, guys. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Wait, are there any crows? Oh, yes, of course. There's got to be a crow on the Ludendorff Cemetery sign again. We always see that crow every single time. It's just waiting for us. Perfect. So now every single person is in North Yankton. We have Franklin, and there's also Michael over there as well. So the first thing I need to do is make sure none of these characters end up speaking to each other. So I'm going to keep them distance apart, and I think that'll be okay. And something I love is that in the midst of all of this, whilst we're getting completely spooked out by ghosts, Franklin and Trevor are playing on their phone like they don't care. Oh, there's a crow on the angel. Of course, of course. We also have Franklin over there and Trevor just over there. There's so many crows. There's a crow on the angel, a crow on the wall, three crows on the wall. There's also two on that one as well. I really don't like the fact there's so many crows. I just don't get it. I don't get it at all. But in the last episode, we did hear quite a few really strange noises. It felt like there was a buzzing coming from the gravestone, and I just don't know how to explain it. I really don't. But there was something coming from the gravestone. And furthermore, I could hear footsteps around me, and I could hear something in the wind. Something. I'm not sure what it was, but it felt like he was speaking to us. But nonetheless, there were quite a few unexplainable noises in this location. So I just need to make sure that I'm keeping an eye. Trevor and Franklin just on their phone. How's it going? I'm just keeping an eye on those two. And I can still hear the spade. I can still hear the spade. It sounds like a spade going into the snow. I wonder if we'll hear that buzzing as well, because we definitely heard a buzzing. That would be so weird if we heard it again. I've never heard something like that in GTA. I hate the spade. I really do. Just some crows. We can only hear the crows. Oh my days. The more I listen to that spade in the ground, the more I think to myself about how something is going to jump out at me. Like, I have this horrible feeling of just turning around and there being a ghost there. Just, like, shouting or just moving. Right next to that gravestone, literally, there's loads of weird sounds coming from it. I can hear a spade as if someone's digging it. Something which you guys have pointed out is that along the fence, it kind of flickers. It's really strange. Like, it's loads of shadows just moving along the bush and stuff. And it looks really weird. Some of you guys have said they look like ghosts and stuff. But along this fence right here, it's like there's something moving along the hedge. It's really strange. Let's go inside the gravestone. Anything? Because this isn't spooky at all. Plenty of crows to go around, though. Plenty of crows. I can still hear that shovel. I'm trying to phase it out so I don't have to listen to it all the time. I may have said this in previous videos, but this angel really, really scares me. I think there's only one of them in the graveyard. If you guys see anything as well, let me know in the comments. There's like a really deep rumble coming from the distance. What is that? I think that's the helicopter. Let's keep walking through this and see if we get pushed over. I can imagine if we do, I'm going to be under my desk before I can even turn around, guys. Like, before I even touch the floor, I'm going to be under my desk. 321, 322, 323. Let's go in first person. 324. Still nothing. Come on. Where's this ghost? Where's the ghost? Where are you, Brad? Come on, dude. Come on, dude. This is so weird. I still haven't heard anything. In the previous video, we heard loads of strange sounds. Trevor and Franklin are still there. But I can't hear anything and I can't see anything right over here. So we're going to go into the next one, guys. We're doing the next one. I'm just going to start alternating between characters. I think that's going to be the best thing to do. So if I just stay down here, I can still see Trevor and Franklin. But at the same time, I don't want to go up to where the grave is. Because when I change the time, I want everything to refresh. How's it going, Crow? Are you still eating snow? Are you kidding me? Okay, so I'm going to change the time, guys. We're going to change the time. Let's go for 1 in the morning. There we go. 12 minutes to 1. If we go back over to the grave. And this time around, I'm going to bring all of the characters over here. We're going to alternate between the characters, guys. Let me go over to Franklin. Let's bring him up here, guys. We haven't done this, so there's always a possibility. But it would make sense that the ghost would go after Michael, because he is the person who went behind Brad's back. Trevor and Franklin didn't. Wait, what are you doing, Franklin? He's like walking. He walked straight through the wall. Oh my days. I'm going to get all the characters back here because we're going to have to, because now they're all walking away doing their own thing. How's it going, Franklin? You enjoying your crisps? Parlor Springs Aerial Tramway. Special 2-for-1 voucher inside. Sweet. So if you guys want to take the cart up Mount Chiliad, you guys can. And he's left some crisps. He's left 2 behind. Franklin, you can't just leave 2. Let's go over to North Yankton, though. Let's get all the characters here. And there we go. We now have Trevor over here. So as you guys can see, there's Franklin just over there. There's also Michael over there as well. So I'm going to change the time and the weather. So it's foggy and I'm going to change the time to, let's do 1:18. Let's get straight into this, guys. Let's just do 1:18. So as you guys can see, everyone's still here. I can still hear the shovel. There's like a shovel coming right from this grave. It's like a shovel sound. It's really strange. All right, where do we put Trevor? I'm going to put Trevor. I don't want to put him right next to the steps because that's where people are going to be walking up. So I'm going to put Trevor over in this corner. Over in this corner, we have Trevor. Let's put Michael next. Let's do Michael. Let's go over to him. Well, something I noticed is when we walked through this, you could hear loads of motors. I can't hear them this time. But I remember in a previous video, you could hear like loads of motors and stuff. And a cool theory you guys said is that we have to take out all of these lights. I mean, possibly that could work. That could work, guys. But I might try that for another video because that would take a while. But it could work. It's a cool theory. But over here, I'm going to leave Michael... I think I'm going to leave him closer to the grave because he is honestly the person, I think, who needs to encounter this ghost. So if we leave Michael over here and go over to Franklin and bring Franklin over to this location as well. So come on, dude, come on. What time is it as well? It's 2:20. Perfect. All right, we've got plenty of time. Something which I noticed, and I'm going to take a look. Are there any emails? I want to see his emails because something which you guys have been asking me to do is see where the person in the taxi, I'm not too sure if you guys know, if you watch my videos for a while, there's someone in a taxi who Franklin sends off into the distance once you do end up completing campaign. I think it's after any of the missions because Franklin isn't taken out. You guys have been asking me to follow that taxi, so maybe in another video, we'll follow it. Yeah, there's no one in the email, but let's go up here. Where's Trevor? There's Trevor. I can hear it. I can... I actually don't like this. I can legit hear something. It's getting louder as well. What is that? It's like a buzzing. It's louder over. I don't know what it is. It's like louder over here. It's not over there. Moving. You can hear it from like the graveside. I legit don't even want to go. I'm just walking through. Oh my days. I'm gonna go over to Michael. Where are you, Michael? Wait, where's Michael? You're actually kidding me. What? Like, what? Am I missing something? Michael spawned at the hospital. Where's Trevor? Is he... Like, the moment I got all the characters up there, and the moment we took Michael there, and then we went over to Franklin, and we walked over to that location, and then we heard the buzzing... And come to think of it, I don't think Michael was there. He mustn't have been there. He couldn't have been there. And the buzzing was moving towards the grave. It kind of like, it started on the steps. So if you walked up the steps, you would hear the buzzing. And then it kind of moved its way towards the gravestone. And that's not the first time I've heard the buzzing. That's not just a random coincidence. I've heard it before. This is something else. This is something else, guys. Michael was taken out. Like, he spawned in the hospital. That's happened to us in previous episodes where the character has been taken out and put in hospital. I believe last time it happened to Franklin, we could hear a buzzing, and the buzzing was moving, and it was kind of, it went straight to the gravestone. It started on the steps and went to the gravestone, and that's not the first time I've heard the buzzing. I've heard it before. It's really rare, but you can hear it, guys. I'm gonna end the video here, guys, because I don't know what else I can do, but this is crazy, and oh my days. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to smash that thumbs up button. That'll be amazing, guys. I recommend you do end up subscribing to the channel, though, because I'm going to keep you updated on this mystery. And if you guys have found anything to do with this Easter egg, let me know in the comments. If you guys saw anything in this video, tweet me a photo or let me know in the comments. But nonetheless, guys, this is insane. And I don't know what else to do. This is crazy. So until next time, guys, I'm going to continue this if you want me to. So let me know in the comments what you would like me to test out next. But this is insane. It is so damn scary. And this is crazy. I don't even know what else to say. So thank you so much for watching, guys. My name is Nort. And until next time, stay absolutely awesome. I'll see you guys in the next video.